Students, today's topic we'll see about the plosives. With respect to pronunciation, the plosives we have seen yesterday, peel, appoint, slip. And then we have seen the minimal pairs also, non-finite verbs. Today we'll continue with the simile and metaphor. Simile is a literary device where we see which are compared to two different things. It is an attempt to make a description more or less vivid. Like her hair is as black as coal. Here the comparison of hair and coal both are given. Same way she is as brave as lion. Her braveness is compared to lion. Her eyes sparkle like diamonds. Here the eyes are compared to the diamonds. So simile is comparison here. Few more examples. The water was as black as night. My love is like a red rose. The room was so warm, it was like a sauna. So simile here is a literary device which has comparison of two different things, which uses most of the time like words like or as. Metaphor. Metaphor is also a literary device which is similar to the simile used in descriptive writing. Unlike a simile which compares two different things, a metaphor equates two different things without using the words. Like, as, which we see in simile is not used in metaphor. Example, the city is a concrete jungle. The city is not a jungle, but it is compared to as a concrete jungle. Her words were poison. No one's words will be like poison, but like they say, through words we can make someone live, someone die. It's comparison that her words are like poison. All the words a stage, like the whole world is a stage. So metaphor, more or less we are saying this as it is comparatively real. But in simile we are comparative both of them using the words like and as. So this was about simile and metaphor with respect to vocabulary. If we see the spelling, use of I, E and EI. Use of IE comes most of the time before E. Or else, but in few exceptions, except before C. Except after C. More or less they are same, but we have to do few examples. One example, H-R. If we see H-R, we have to see this EI or IE. So HEIR will be the comparison, higher. Next, if we see achieve, ACH-BE, we have to take it IE. The same if we take leisure, L-SURE, we have to keep EI. So I before E, believe, chief, priest, friend, patient. Except after C, ceiling, desert, receipt, receive, transceiver. Or when sounding like A, we have to say neighbor, ween, wait, way, sight. So this was with respect to spelling. If you see punctuation, semicolon comes most of the time when we are not completing a sentence. We are saying part of the sentence and again we are continuing. He needed to see a doctor. Semicolon, he hurt himself because of a accident, something like that. By playing football, by playing volleyball, something. So the sentence is not completed, we use semicolon in between. These trousers were ruined, hopefully, semicolon, hopefully your trailer can mend it. So, the weather was terrible, it wouldn't stop raining. Here, after it, we have to keep the semicolon, wouldn't stop raining. Few places we will not have the semicolon, like, I want to go to the library, but I think it might be closed today. Are you okay traveling by bus, or do you want to travel by train? Sometimes we may keep semicolon also in between, but it is not of much use here. So even if we don't keep, it's not a mistake in such cases. Semicolon is for this term, I don't think it's going to come. We'll just see it for 1 mark. Conversation, important bit which may come for at least 5 marks, like asking for information. Here examples. Imagine you are in the following situations. You have to attend a job interview with an organization you admire. You are meeting the receptionist. You are asking few doubts to her. You express your doubts and he or she is answering you. How the questionnaire is going between you. You are the person who is in need of job or information. How will you ask them? How will they give reply to you? So You should start the conversation in a very pleasing way, polite way, courteous way. That is asking for information, which is an important and expected question. Excuse me, I am sorry to bother you. Can you help me? Do you mind helping me? So in this way, in polite way, we can ask them questions. If they are busy, they will tell us, please wait for some time. After waiting for some time, we have to again pose a question to them and ask them and get our reply. The situations, the job interview, the first one, and next one, you're working on your profession presentation, that is professional presentation, but do not know how to insert a table, that is slide presentation. These two bits can come for exam, or else any live situations you are in need of some information, in search of the nearest police station, nearest post office, asking them for way, how they guide you. So this can be one of the question. Next is about reading passage, where we have Hyderabad, the heart of Telangana. This, if you imagine, this also we have done in the class. You can write of your own, but remember to write the first. We are having four paragraphs. First paragraph, city of Hyderabad is located in the heart of Telangana. Who built it? The Chowmahan Palace, Salarjung Museum, the population present there is important. Second paragraph, when you see the city of pearls, Hyderabad's other name is city of pearls. If you remember the king's and queen's name, the Nizam ruler's name, it's good, well and good. Or else just write and remember the tourist places. Why is Hyderabad famous for what is it's well known for? The food of the place, Hyderabad biryani, the culture, the tradition of the people, their costumes. All this if you combine and write together, it will get us more marks. In 1947, the Nizam of Hyderabad about the Operation Polo. It's a very important point. Later, the last but not the least, about the June 2nd, 2014, mentioning about the movement of, following the movement of Telangana, the separation of Telangana. On the whole, few important points should be mentioned. You can write this of your own. This was with respect to reading passage, Hyderabad, the heart of Telangana. We'll stop for today. Thank you.